Class 12th, welcome to the online tutorial sessions for economics. I am Avinash Lambert, your economics guru, and today we are going to continue our sixth chapter, which is income determination and multiplier. Now, in today's video, we are going to do the second approach. In the previous video, we studied the aggregate demand and aggregate supplies approach. In today's video, we are going to do the second approach, which is savings and investment approach. This is the second approach for determining the equilibrium level. Fine? Equilibrium level of income, total output, and employment. I already told you that in this unit, in Keynes theory, the employment, the outcome, the output, and the income all are constituted as same thing, because if we want to increase the output, if we want to increase the profit, the income, you need to increase all these things simultaneously. So, savings and investment approach. Let's start. Savings and investment approach means the equilibrium level of national income. The equilibrium level of national income can be determined by the point where exempt savings are equal to the exempt investments. What is exempt investment and exempt savings? I told you it is the planned saving and it is the planned investments. Planned saving by the consumers and planned investments by the investors, the producer. So, this is the planned, not actual. The planned investments and planned saving, when they are equal to each other, at that point we can determine the equilibrium level of national income. I hope you have understood. Now, students, at equilibrium level, you already studied that aggregate demand is equal to aggregate supply. And I am not just saying things up, it can be proved. AD is equal to AS. You already know that. But now, you already know the formula of aggregate demand, which is C plus I. If you remember, right? C plus I. And what is the formula of aggregate supply? Aggregate supply can be written as Y, and also aggregate supply can be written as C plus S. Remember, right? Now, with this equation, you can cut the consumption, and the remaining which is left, it can be written as I is equal to S, or S is equal to I. So that's how investment and savings, the point where they are equal, equilibrium level can be determined. I hope you have understood. So there are two formulas for equilibrium level. One is AD is equal to S and point I is equal to S. Now, if you remember the previous graph, what was there? It was the same graph. 0 to 60 was the income and the consumption. I was taken at 0 level of income, the consumption was taken as 60, and then there was a linear increase, the constant increase of 70 per 100 income. Fine, there was an increase of 70 consumption at every 100 increase in income. Now let's calculate again. That is the same calculation which we did in the previous video. Let's do it again. Savings, we have to calculate saving. How do we calculate it? Income minus consumption. 0 minus 60, it will be minus 60. 100 minus 130, minus 30. 200 minus 200, that is 0. 300 minus 270, that is 30. 400 minus 340, that is 60. 500 minus 410, that is 90. 600 minus 480, that is 120. Now, for the investments, you already know that investment we have to take as the autonomous investments. The investments are always equal in the Keynes theory. This chapter, the whole unit, in which you have to take only autonomous investments, that is, you have to take a constant amount. In the previous video, we had taken 60 as the investment. So in this also, because the example is same, we have to take the same investment, that is 60. Why I am taking 60? Just for the calculation, for the diagram that can be made easily. Otherwise, you can take any value, 40, 50, 80, you can take any value. Fine. So I am taking 60 as the autonomous investments. Here it is, 60. Now, you need only this much. If you want, you can calculate AD and AS also. Fine, no problem. We will calculate AD and AS also. AD and AS. Now, how to calculate AD and AS? C plus I, that is 120. C plus I, that is 190. 2, 60. 3, 30. 4, 100. That is 470. And this is 540. Is that clear? 540. Now, calculate aggregate supply. Aggregate supply is 0. C plus S, 0. Then it will be 100. Then 200. Then 300. Then 400. 500. And 600. That income is always equal to the aggregate supply. We can say that Y is equal to AS. Fine, in the previous video we studied that Y is equal to AS. So this will be your graph, sorry, the schedule. Now here you can see, in the previous video we took out the equilibrium level of 400, because here 400 was equal to 400, AD was equal to AS. This was the equilibrium point. But here also, in the sales and investment approach, this is again the point of equilibrium, because if you see the saving and investment, here saving and investments are also equal, that is 60 is equal to 60. So 400 is equal to 400, 60 is equal to 60. I told you AD is equal to AS, it means C plus I is equal to CS. C and C you have to cut it down, and the remaining I and S are equal to each other. So here on this level of income, on 400 level of income, savings and investments are equal to each other, as the aggregate demand and aggregate supply are equal to each other. I hope you have understood this. Now students, you have to complete a diagram, a very beautiful diagram. You have to make the main points, the main marks you will get for this topic will be given on the basis of the diagram. You have to draw a very clear-cut diagram. You have to draw the schedule also, and you have to mention what is saving investment approach. But the main thing you have to show is the diagram. Now students, you have to draw a savings and investment curve. Savings and investment curve, and on the basis of that you have to show the equilibrium. Now you already know that saving curve is always started from the below the origin point. Always starts from the below the origin point. So draw a savings curve. Suppose I am taking this point as minus 60. Fine. Now from this point, you have to draw a savings curve. Draw a savings curve. This is your saving curve. Fine. Now, this is your saving curve, and you have to draw an investment curve. Now students, investment curve, we have to always take the autonomous investment. You know that. So draw a straight line which is parallel to the x-axis. Suppose this is the point 60, this is the 60, and draw a straight line which is parallel to x-axis. So this is your investment curve. Now you can see a point where both are intersecting, mark it as point E. So this is the point E. Now you can say that if you increase that point to the income levels axis, on this x-axis, you will get a point. Suppose this is point Y. This is point Y. So we can say that at income level of Y, income level of Y, this will be 400. 100, 200, 300, 400. This will be 400. I have named it, instead of 400, I have named it as Y. Now at the income level of Y, the equilibrium level is on point E. How you have calculated the equilibrium level? By drawing the savings curve and the investment curve, and the point where they are intersecting, that point is the level of equilibrium, and the level of income will be at point Y. Now that's how you are going to draw your diagram. I hope you have understood that. Now I want you all to take a screenshot so that you can complete your notes by today only. Now this is not finished, this is not over yet. You have a few things to remind in this topic. Let's go to that topic. The next thing about this graph is that there will be other points also apart from the equilibrium point. There are parts which are on the left side of the equilibrium, and there will be parts which will be on the right side of the equilibrium. Now let's see the left part of this equilibrium. Suppose this is this Y, this point Y is a point of income. Now instead of taking Y as the income, I want to take the point A. Suppose I have to take this point. Now at this point A, I want to see where my savings and investments stands. I'll draw a line. Now here if you see the equilibrium, it's not happening there. The investment and saving curve are not intersecting each other. Instead, investments are more than the saving. See, the investment curve is on the upper of this saving curve. So we can say that at this point that savings are less than investments, or investments are more than savings. You can write it as both the things. Now this scenario where S is less than I, or savings is less than investment. Now what does this mean? It means that households are consuming more. It means that households are consuming more. We can say that they are consuming more and they are saving less. People are consuming more and they are saving less. It becomes a situation where the people want to buy more. They have planned to buy more. So this makes the situation of aggregate demand is more than aggregate supply. Because people doesn't want to save, they want to expand it. They want the consumption to do. Therefore, they want to buy more. Therefore, aggregate demand is more than aggregate supply. And therefore, the savings are less than investments. It means that households are consuming more and saving less than what? Than the firms. Firms thought that you are going to demand for 5 boxes. But no, you demanded for 10 boxes and the firms have prepared only 5 boxes. So they are in a situation of loss. As a result, the inventories will fall. Whatever they will be saving in their stock, they will finish. They will diminish slowly and slowly, right? Whatever they have produced, that will be finished, that will be utilized, that will be bought, that will be diminished slowly and slowly, and below the desired level. The inventories, the stock will fall. And to bring the inventory back, if they want to bring the inventory back to the desired level, firms will increase the production. Yes. The situation is aggregate demand is more than aggregate supply. So here the firms have to increase their production. They have to increase their production. Suppose they were producing at the income level of point A. Now they have to increase their production. They will increase their production from point A to slowly and slowly they will move it to towards the right, and there will be a point Y where they will be stopping. Why? Because at point Y there is the equilibrium. So the firms will increase the production from point OA to OY. Until when? Till savings becomes equal to the inventory, that is S is equal to I. Unless and until the savings become equal to the investment, the production will goes on to increase and increase. Until and unless savings becomes equal to the investment. It's just like the previous video, but here instead of aggregate demand and aggregate supply, you have savings and investments. Now, what about the right hand side of this curve? Suppose I have taken this point, the income level I have taken is point B. I have named it as point B. Now, let's see. Now, at this point, you can easily see that the savings are more than the investments, which says that the people want to save more and they don't want to consume. They want to save more and they don't want to consume more. Therefore, this becomes the situation of aggregate demand is less than aggregate supply. It's just like that situation. Here, people want to save more. They don't want to expend. Therefore, they will be saving some money. And if they are not doing the consumption, they have stopped the consumption, it means the inventories in the market, they will increase more. People are not going to buy the products of the firms. Therefore, the inventory will increase. Now, when savings is more than investment, what does that mean? It means that households are saving more and not consuming much as the firms expect them to. They are saving more and not consuming much. As a result, inventories will rise above the desired level. Whatever the firms have thought about the inventory level, that will rise because people are not buying their products. And to clear the unwanted stock, if they want to finish, they want to clear their unwanted stock, in that case, what the firm will do? Firm will reduce the production. If they reduce the production, then people are going to buy their rise inventories, and slowly that inventories will be diminishing. So they will be decreasing. They will be reducing their production from OB to OY. Suppose they were producing OB level of output, OB level, but their inventories are increasing again, and people are not buying their product as they desired. So they will be decreasing. They will decrease their production slowly to the left, and they will be decreasing till savings become equal to the investments. Means they will be decreasing until and unless they found the equilibrium level. Till savings become equal to the investment. That is, saving becomes equal to the investment. So that is the whole scenario. That is the whole thing of this savings and investment approach. I think you have understood it a lot. And that's all for this video. Stay home, stay safe, and see you soon.